Hello, my name is Abasesoro Fangbemi. I am a data scientist from Ubisoft China AI and Data Lab, and I'm glad to introduce to you today ZooBuilder, which is a project we put in place to estimate the 2D and 3D pose of animals from videos using some machine learning models that we have trained on a set of synthetic data generated internally. As some of you might know, Ubisoft has in some of its games, such as the Far Cry series or the Assassin's Creed series, a large number of animals that have been animated and brought into the game world. To create those animations, animators have to rely on either keyframe animation techniques or motion capture techniques. However, each of those two approaches has its own limitations and challenges. For the motion capture approach, for example, it is very difficult to bring in a mockup room a large animal such as an elephant. But more importantly, the unpredictable behavior of animals, especially wild animals, make it difficult to use mockup to capture some of their specific actions or motions. On the other hand, keyframe animations are very time-consuming and expensive to produce. Depending on the animals, we estimate the workload to vary between 100 man days to 500 man days. 100 for a secondary animal with minimal animations like a deer, which runs away when it sees the player. And 500 for primary animals such as pets or predators that can interact with the player. All these make animation prototyping for animal very expensive, and once production starts, it is very difficult to change the list of animals for which animation have been already created. In parallel to this, a lot of research have been conducted to successfully predict the 2D and 3D pose and shape of humans from images or videos using some machine learning techniques. This is made possible thanks to the relative abundance of datasets for humans in comparison to animals. While it is still a challenge to acquire immense and high-quality human datasets for such tasks, it is even more difficult to get hands on similar datasets for animals. Hence, the slow progress on animal pose and shape estimation. Having this in mind, ZooBuilder was designed with the purpose to automate the creation of animals' animation using machine learning models. But in order to do that, we firstly have to overcome the big problem of lack of data that are needed to train such machine learning models. To generate those data, we leverage the expertise of the Ubisoft Wildlife team in China, which has a rich catalog of animal animation assets previously created for some of Ubisoft games. Given their assets, we developed a semi-automated process to generate the training data. The data mainly consists of images of the animal captured from different camera angles, the 2D and 3D coordinates of the joints that compose the skeleton of the animal on each frame, together with some camera parameters. The process of generating those data goes as follows. We firstly import in Motion Builder the keyframe animation file of the animal, then put within the scene a set of cameras that are centered on the animal. For each frame of the animation and for each camera perspective, we extract the 3D world coordinates of 37 joints that compose the skeleton of the animal, together with some camera parameters such as camera 3D world coordinates, the 3D world coordinate of its focal point, and its projection matrix. In addition to those, we also extracted for each frame and for each camera the image captured by the camera with a transparent background. All these represent the raw data extracted from the FBX animation file. To train the machine learning models, we need to transform those raw data into different formats required for each model. Hence, using the camera parameters data, We converted the 3D world coordinates of the joints to their 3D camera view coordinates, and then converted the 3D camera view coordinate into 2D image coordinates. Since our initial images data were also created with a transparent background, we also processed those images by adding some fake backgrounds. This in order to make them look a bit more realistic. On the right side are some samples of our datasets showing the cougar on a background with the 2D coordinates of the joints. Using those synthetic data, we retrained two machine learning models originally designed for human 2D and 3D pose estimations. The first model for 2D pose estimation is OpenPose. It infers 2D coordinates of joint from single image by predicting the heat map of each joint together with a part affinity field vector that represents the relationship between joints that are connected. Hence, during the training phase, we use the images as features and the 2D image coordinates as label for that model. Because OpenPose operates only on single image, it does not take into account the temporal information or features that might be present in videos. To exploit those temporal information, we retrain a 3D pose estimation model based on LSTM called Post3D, which takes as inputs a sequence of 2D coordinates from 5 consecutive frames and from which it extracts some temporal features to infer the corresponding sequence of 3D coordinates. During the training phase of those models, we perform some traditional data augmentation on the data, for example, by flipping the images, changing the contrast or brightness, or by adding some noise. But for the OpenPose model in particular, we perform other data transformation on the image to ensure that our synthetic training data and the real test data share the same data distribution. For that, during both the training and the testing phase, we transform the images either by applying the same style transfer on them or by simply converting them from color image to grayscale images. At the end, we found that the model trained with the grayscale images outperformed the one trained on the image with star transfer. After retraining those two models, we integrate them into an end-to-end pipeline called ZooBuilder that takes as inputs a video of an animal together with a static 3D mesh and skeleton of that animal and output the corresponding 3D animation. At the heart of the pipeline result three machine learning models. The first one is an existing pre-trained object detection model called YOLO version 3, which detects the position of the animal on the image. Once detected, we crop that image out of the frame and use the cropped centered image as input to our custom OpenPose model to infer the 2D coordinate of the joints. Once the inference of the 2D joint coordinates are done for all the frames, we use those sequence of 2D joint coordinates as input to our custom Post3D model to infer the sequence of 3D joint coordinates. Finally, those sequence of 3D joint coordinates are used to animate the 3D mesh and skeleton of the animal. Following are some of the results of ZooBuilder on some video from the wild. On the left are the results of OpenPose for 2D pose estimation, and on the right, the result of Post3D for 3D pose estimation. As you can see, the results of ZooBuilder are quite satisfactory, especially when the animal is totally within the frame of the image, or when there is not big occlusion made by some foreign object. This slide shows some results after we apply the 3D animation generated by the machine learning models on a static 3D skeleton to animate the 3D mesh. Initially, after applying directly the 3D animation data from Pose 3D on the static skeleton, we observe some strange twists of the animated 3D mesh. To avoid those twists, we applied some custom constraints by setting some app and target objects for each joint. Also, initially, we started building ZooBuilder by only using 30 joints instead of the current 37 joints. With the 30 joints not including the nose, the ears, or the paw joints, we also observed some abnormal twists, especially around the head, the neck, and the feet. We later on solved those problems by adding those additional joints and also by applying the aforementioned constraints. Those ZooBuilder allow us to generate acceptable 3D animation of animal based on videos. Its performance is still far from perfection and fails under some specific conditions. That is the case when the animal is, for example, occluded by some foreign object, as you can see at the end of this sequence. It also performs poorly when some part of the body of the animal is out of the frame, as shown in this video. One of its other limitations is that it currently only supports one animal, which is the cougar, and the test we performed to see how well it generalized on similar animals, such as the tiger, were not successful. Another limitation of ZooBuilder is that it does not currently handle well input videos containing multiple objects. As you can see in this example, it has difficulty to select and track accurately one of those two animals during the whole sequence. Instead, it keeps bouncing from one target to the other. So currently, we are still working on improving the performance of ZooBuilder by trying to solve these problems, and we hope that by working and collaborating on the topic with our peers, we will be able to achieve further progress on animal pose and shape estimation. Thank you for your attention.